All right, my friends, today is April 16th. For me, it's Veda Day 16, and it just so happens to be the day after the explosions happened at the Boston Marathon. And kind of really, I think, hit me this morning more than it did yesterday. I didn't really try to watch the news that much. I saw that it happened, and there's all sorts of links to all sorts of things on Facebook and social media, but I had my 12-year-old with me yesterday, so I really don't like to watch the negative news with her. It's funny, she obviously sees what's going on. It's in her Instagram feed. But that was kind of funny. I says, "Where do you get your news from?" She goes, "Oh, Instagram." I don't know where I'm going with this. Point being, it kind of hit home this morning when my local news station had on their Facebook link that they had a picture of the child that died. It was an 8-year-old boy. And, it just was just a reminder to me, you know, of how fragile life is. And I immediately was, like, transported back to when I ran my, you know, me of all people running. I did my 5K, and I just remember my child being there. And she was, I think it was a couple years ago, so she was about 9 or 10. And, it just kind of really brought things home. As well as another video that I saw, somebody else is doing this Veda, that she was there about 50 feet from the finish line. You know, and what's the solution here? You know, a friend of mine was telling me about a comedy skit that was on with C.K. Lewis, and he was talking about the food chain and how we are the only species, we're at the top of the food chain. We've got nothing to frickin' worry about. I mean, as far as animals killing us, anybody below us trying to eat us alive, I mean, and then, you know, we have our own shit to deal with on a day-to-day basis. Can you imagine if we had to worry about, you know, being consumed? But the reality is we do. And it's not by anything less than us. It's not another animal. It's each other. I mean, if you really take this a step farther, we're like the only animal in the food chain that frickin' kills each other. I mean, where does that start? And what can you do? And I think, you know, what any of us can do as parents, as teachers, as people who share stuff in social media, all we can do is share love. I mean, love is where it starts and ends and really what it's all about. We are not born, we don't come into the world wielding a sword. We're taught that. Who teaches us that? Who teaches each other, you know, how do we get to that point where we want to harm someone else? Or when somebody else's thoughts or beliefs, you know, we're so angered by those thoughts and beliefs that we want to toss fire onto them or rid them of their life on this earth. How does that happen? How does that happen when somebody gets so angry with someone else that they just want to see them gone? Or a random incident that happened yesterday. It's just so, I don't even know how to grapple with some of this stuff because I don't think that way. And, you know, what can I do? I can just pass on love and pass on, you know, compassion and be the best father I can be the best teacher and try to be the best inspirator that I can. I know this is not inspirational at all, but just kind of, you know, I'm hoping this makes someone out there think that, you know, especially a parent that starts their day and they're so enamored with what they have to get done that day. And, you know, getting to the next, you know, whatever, getting to the store, getting your kids fed, and, you know, getting to work to accumulate money to buy more crap that nobody cares about. You know, if you could just stop and listen and, you know, and share a, share an ear to someone, to a friend. You know, maybe somebody's in really in dire straits, man. Maybe that's some, maybe that person you pass in the street that you don't smile to is really contemplating something serious. You know, be the best person you can be and be a beacon of light to all around you. I guess that's really all I can say. It's really what this is coming to, is just be a beacon of light. That's it, man. I guess my beacon of light today is my shake. Let me just share what I got here. It's, I'm on the clean program, and you don't have to be on the clean program, but just, you know, start your day out with something good. Could be a protein shake, could be a juice, it could be an egg white omelet, it could be something good. But fuel your body in the morning. It's the most important meal of the day to get you going, but for whatever that's worth. I don't even know if I'm going to post this, but I think I, like so many others, are just so confused here. We don't know what that was, what happened, and there's a lot of speculation going on. But the reality is when this is all gone, I mean, this is not going to be gone for a lot of people. This is going to affect a lot of people for a long time. But what you can do is you can continue to be the conduit of love. You can be a conduit for love and a beacon of light. And I hope that resonates with someone today. That's it. As always, more on all this later.